So what do you think an APM does? Like, do they have the same level of, obviously they won't have the same level, but do they have the same kind of work that you mentioned as a product manager of thinking about problems, meeting with stakeholders, or is it more about analyzing the data of the product and like
Right.
what,
So,
where is the role more inclined to?
right. So, an APM is supposed to work under a product manager and get to learn more from him. An APM. So, see, if you are the bottom most part of a food chain, you'll do the grunt work that you have to be very, very clear about. So, yes, it will involve data analysis. You'll have to go and fetch data. You might have to write long queries to get that data. As an APM, the biggest learning that you will have is finding the right data and execution. As I said earlier in this call, is that execution is the easiest part that a product manager does. Execution is not difficult. So as an APM, you are expected to execute products. As you go up in the ladder, you start focusing more on stakeholders and a strategy. An APM is usually told that, hey, we need to build this feature. Can you find more data whether this feature makes sense or not? And if it does make sense, can you ensure that this feature goes out? So that's what usually an APM does. A PM usually thinks of what feature needs to be built. Above to a PM is a senior product manager. Senior product manager usually takes care of a portfolio of products, not just one. And then above the senior product manager, usually there are directors of products, which take care of one vertical of products. And above the director is usually a CPO, which is Chief Product Officer. So a chief CPO is somebody that looks 0% into execution. His role is 100% strategy. A director, maybe 10% execution, 90% strategy. Similarly, at SPM, my role is 50% execution, 50% strategy. But APM is 90% execution, 10% strategy. So it's always good to think about strategy, because one thing we have learned is that anybody can come up with a good idea. So everybody should be encouraged about strategy. But as an APM, you'll be focused more about execution, and that is also important in terms of technical understanding and how software development works. So unless you don't understand that, you cannot go up in the ladder. So yes, for the what I want to say is that you just need to have an open mind and a logical thinking approach to become an APM, and then you'll start learning things on the job.
And I think you need to be more hands-on, like you said, fetching data,
Yes.
like
So
capabilities of
if I
SQL
see
and
SQL, Excel on a CV, that helps in your APM interview. If I see coding, like software development background, that really adds up a lot, because you are eventually working with designers. There might be a couple of designers you are working with, and you'll be working with a large team of developers. You won't get their respect unless you understand their language. I'll be very, very, very frank. You need to talk their language. And if you are a developer yourself, you'll get their respect, and it's really easy to get things done. And it's also helps when they're trying to bullshit you. You need to have enough knowledge to filter out that bullshit. So if you are somebody from software development background, that's a plus plus on your CV, but that's not necessary. But definitely SQL and Excel will help. And I frankly don't see any excuse that you don't need ex don't know Excel and SQL. Doesn't take a lot of time to learn them as well. And that should be definitely on your CV for APM roles.